Now we have a Muslim, supposedly he keep bragging, he keep asking to debate me, and he is from Saudi Arabia. This guy, he sent like 100 texts. I wanna say, challenge Christian Prince. I wanna challenge Christian Prince. Where is the Christian Prince? Can you bring me Christian Prince? Huh? Where is the Christian Prince? Can we find the Christian Prince? So we said to them, okay, bring him. This Saturday, I will be waiting for him. All right. And now it is Saturday. And now it is 4:30 as we agree. And guess what he sent me finally just a minute ago? He said he don't want to debate me. He want me to drink poison. His text. If you accept to drink poison as your Bible, read, what the Muslim they speak about, they say that in the Bible, in the book of Mark, it says that if you drink poison, you will not die. Now, you know, this is because you are an ignorant and because you are a foolish person who do not understand your own books. So how you can understand our own books? What is the poison here meant? The book of Psalm, and you can read those verses, 140 from 1 to 4, and you will see what is the poison here meant. We Christians believe that all the apostles of Jesus, all the first leaders of our churches, they've been either crucified, beheaded, or been feeding to animals to eat them alive. So there is nowhere in Christianity it means such a thing that nobody can hurt you physically. So where in the Bible it says that and meant literally that you will not die? Where in Christianity it teach if you became a Christian you don't die? The Messiah, he said, whoever believe in me and die will live. So you die and you will die. That is a must. So my friend Abdul, if you decide to be a foolish man like your prophet, this is your business, but don't carry your foolishness to our Bible. Our Bible is very deep, have nothing to do with the stupidity. However, it's your prophet who said, Allah apostle said, he who eats seven ajwa, and notice here, your prophet is giving us a very clear description for his prescription. He's a doctor, Muhammad. Dr. Muhammad, he have a degree in anti-poison and magic. If we go here, we will see the wise Muhammad, Dr. Muhammad, peace upon him, who have a degree in magic resistance, saying, Allah apostle said, who eats seven ajwa, dates every morning, will not be affected by poison or magic on the day he eats them. Who is the Muslim want to practice this? You see, this is literally, this is not spiritually. This is not as you can't tell me this is spiritual. This we're talking about eating ajwa. Ajwa is not the word of God, is it in Islam? Your prophet, he did not say the one who read Quran. No, he said he'll eat ajwa. So you cannot play the game and say, oh, this is he meant something else. He means something spiritual. Whoever eats seven ajwa, and here look, Muhammad, he is giving us the right number. Like if you eat six, you will die. If you eat five, you will die. If you eat six and a half, you will die. You have to eat exactly seven. If you don't eat exactly seven, you are in trouble. And for sure, Muhammad, he knew what he's talking about. He's the prophet of Allah. Because Muhammad in the Quran, he said that Allah said, if Muhammad fabricating word claiming it is from God, Allah will cut his artery. Do you see it? It's a revelation from the Lord of the world, the Lord of the ring. And if he had invented false saying concerning us, if he who Muhammad, we assuredly had taken him by his right hand, and we then severed his life artery. And this is exactly what Muhammad said in the hadith, that he is dying by the poison which is cutting his artery.
Nabi, dalam penyakitnya yang membuatnya meninggal, sering berkata, "Oh Aisyah, Saya masih merasakan sakit yang disebabkan oleh makanan yang saya makan di Khaibar, dan saat ini, saya merasa seolah-olah urat nadi saya terpotong dari racun itu.
Do you see it?
So Muhammad, now this is the only time Muhammad really he predicted how he would die. He was a prophet at this moment, which means he was a false prophet, who his death proven to us that he is a false prophet. And I believe strongly the reason that he died in that way, our Lord, he wanted to prove to us, not the Lord of Muhammad, that Muhammad is a false prophet. Because if I say to you, if I am lying, may God, God told me he will kill me in certain way. And that death, exactly what happened. What does that mean? You know what I mean? Muhammad saying that Allah told him that if Muhammad is inventing Quran, fabricating words, it's not from God. This God, whoever he was going to punish him like this. And nobody can hold us from punishing him. And that will be something to remember for anyone who do evil. Muhammad, he said that he never thought he will die in such a death. When he made and fabricated those verses, he never thought he will die in such a death. Isn't it obvious?
Same time, I find it very funny that everybody die except Jesus in Islam. You see, Islam is like a kind of American movie. There's a guy who have a gun and he shoot everybody, and he is the only one who don't get injured. And if he get injured, nothing happened to him, but everybody die. That is Isa, the Muslim. Even the Prophet Muhammad himself, he die. And he die by poison, as we will show you and prove it to you. But Isa, the Muslim, is like a Rambo in Islam. He never die. This guy, Rambo, Isa, everybody die. It doesn't matter who. Moses died, Muhammad died, the enemy of Islam died, the enemy of Muhammad died, everybody died. Khadija died, Aisha died, Abu Bakr died, Umar died, except Rambo. And who is Rambo in Islam? That is the Messiah.
This cult, obviously, is easy to expose. Anyone?